Ay nako, Carmina, ika nga ng ating mga ano, lola at lola, ang mag-ganchillo ay di biro.
O, maghapon ka na kayo ko. Pero itong craft na ito, na dati lamang nakikita natin sa mga lola natin, ha, ay nagkakaroon na ng revival.
In fact, nagiging fashion statement mga for some, you know, at para sa iba, people have actually started making their own knitwear.
And they say, Mishy, if you want something done right, you better do it yourself. And that's exactly what Charlene Alcanices did when she picked up some yarn and a set of knitting needles and started crocheting her own accessories. Bantakin mo. Charlene's DIY passion for hand-knit fashion turned just a crafty hobby into a business. And it's called Jazzyphelle Fiber Arts, and she's here today with her loving husband Mike to share with us her collection of chunky and funky handmade accessories that are perfect additions to anyone's wardrobe this fall. Mr. and Mrs., welcome to Adobo Nation.
Hello. Thank you. Hello.
Thank you.
Ang galing nito. Mamaya ho, mga ka-nation, makikita nyo yung different
different creations. Ways, exactly. Different ways to interpret this art.
So, Charlene, what inspired you to go into knitting?
You know, it was actually just taught to me by a friend. Found out she knitted, and I said, teach it to me. And that was probably about 10 years ago.
Wow.
Yeah, about 10 years ago. And that's how it all started. She taught it, and I haven't stopped since
and
then.
And within those 10 years, when did you realize, oh, maybe I can make some extra money doing this?
Just recently.
Okay.
Just recently. So it really started from our trip back from New York last October, when we went to Soho, and I got really inspired just by the women there.
And were they wearing a lot of knitwear?
They were, and not so much just knitwear, it's just very chunky, funky type scarves, hats, made out of just different material.
Okay, so what we're seeing right now, modeled by our favorite twins, next to mine,
second favorite
Bernadette and Beverly, tell us about the hats. And the scarf.
Okay, so the cowl that Beverly is wearing is actually what was inspired by my trip over to New York. And this is a 3-in-1. So as you can see, she wears it over her head. Now she's wearing it just right around her neck. And then you can actually bring it down over the shoulders.
Okay. I love that.
So it's a 3-in-1. It's a multitasking.
Twins talaga healthy.
Absolutely. And she's pairing it with a girlfriend bangle. That piece was actually inspired just by my girlfriends.
Yeah. And that is chunky and funky.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah. And Bernadette is wearing the cloche hat. And that's very, very in right now, especially with the fedora type style.
Right.
Yeah.
I love it. I love how small the brim is.
So kapag mahahawakan yung kanation, it looks like it's very, you know, sturdy, but it's also very soft, it's functional, wearable.
Definitely.
It's
functional,
wearable art.
Yes.
So Mike, tell us about the company. How did you come up with the name Jazzyphelle?
Well, Jazzyphelle is actually the name of our three children. Jazz, Zyph, and Audrey L.
Okay.
And you know, everything that we do with love and for our kids. And so we haven't actually seen a single cent, you know.
Really?
Everything goes to them, and including everything that we create and we make, we definitely keep them close to our hearts when we do it.
That's
so
fantastic.
Mention like Gita Nat, and that it's of course it's functional wearable art for women, but guys, look at this.
Like that.
Yes.
I am
so
loving
what
that
I really wanted to point out is that when you actually do go onto our website, a lot of that's modeled is by me, but it's very functional across for the men as well.
Absolutely.
So here, I love that chain.
Oh, thank you. So this is the unbreakable knit chain that my brother Chuck is wearing. It's very hip hop.
One of the things that we really wanted to focus is when these guys go out, we want a conversational piece.
Right.
You know, right away, you know, you want to grab the attention. You want to have a woman ask you, "Hey, where did you get that? What is that?"
Like your bow tie.
Oh, yes, my wife made this.
It's
one of my favorites.
Yeah. So why do you think that knitwear is so associated with the season that we're in? This is obviously the fall edition of Adobo Nation. Why is knitwear and fall like such a dynamic duo?
Well, you know, knitting is actually has been around for a very long time. You know, people have been knitting blankets and things to kind of keep warm. All we're doing is we're being creative with recreating knitwear to fit our modern age and our style. So, you know, we created something that's functional and it still looks good.
I noticed that you actually have other items here that are kind of knitted, semi-knitted, or have a little bit of that kind of element in it, but I mean, they're gorgeous and they're very unique.
And actually, what's really good about it is that you don't necessarily have to wear it on yourself. You can even wear it on your
put it on your purse.
Yes, exactly. Or you can take one of the brooches and put it with one of the scarves, right, or even the hats. So
what's nice about their pieces, Mish, napansin ko lang ha, parang it's an extension of your personality.
Yes,
whatever
absolutely.
Personality you have, you just, yeah, you just wear it.
It right. doesn't look right. like it's been, you know, like branded, yeah, or right. you know, like focus like, group.
Yeah. It's kind of like right. when you go shopping, yeah, you know, you see something great, but it's not quite your color. You're not right. quite mature, your length.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Well, we want to bridge that for you.
And mm-hmm. I don't know if it makes sense, but sometimes when people wear accessories, you tend to see the accessory and not the person. But
right.
then when,
right.
like these fabulous models behind you, we don't know their names. We don't, you don't know
we
them.
We don't know where they came from.
But more or less, you get to see their personalities already through the accessories that they're wearing.
Absolutely.
Right. Very nice. So tip, maybe advice, tips for those
who want to start their own DIY yeah. business, you know, anything that you've learned?
You know, what I've learned going into this is definitely, since I am married,
and
collaborating
she says that with much gusto and
yeah. with much love and affection. It's really knowing that you're going in with the best intentions, mm-hmm. You know, and when we went into this venture, it was really just to do it because I'm passionate about this
right.
hobby,
mm-hmm.
And to just go for it.
The one thing that I'm very proud of is that my wife was able to follow her heart. And I think that's very important when going into anything. You have to enjoy it for yourself first.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
The business will follow, but let your heart lead the way.
This girl is melting with a sincere love and appreciation and passion
we'll
emanating from
yes,
you guys.
We'll definitely have
so
you
where
back
can,
on the show.
Where can we find that. This before mm-hmm. before we end the segment? Where can we find Jazzyphelle?
So right now you can find Jazzyphelle on the Etsy website. So if you go to www.jazzyphellefiberarts.etsy.com
mm-hmm.
or
you can go on this website. I don't know if you guys have heard about it. It's called Facebook.
Oh, that's yes,
right, right?
It's really yeah. big right now.
And add us, and we're under Jazzyphelle Fiber Arts.
Yeah, so thumbs up us.
Yeah,
all right.
Definitely.
And then we also have an email address, Jazzyphelle Fiber Arts, all one word,
mm-hmm.
At yahoo.com.
All right. Kung makalimutan niyo lahat yun, mga ka-nation, just go to adobonation.tv and we will show you the way.
Yes.
Salamat.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks for having us.
Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you very much, gorgeous models.
Thank you very much.
It was great having you guys.
Please keep us updated on your future projects.
Will do.
Best of luck to you both.
Great.